Hello everyone, today we will be creating a project for matrix multiplication using DMA. First we are going to create a new project in Vivaldi HLS. Now we are redirecting our folder, we are going to the folder where all the files are present. We need to add the main file as well as our top function. Since we don't have any test bench file, we will be skipping that particular part. Later on, we need to specify the board which we are going to work on. In this particular case, we are working with PingZ2. In this window, we can see our main file as well as header file which we have previously added to the project. And in the header file, we define the matrix size and all. Like, since we are working with 2 3x3 matrices, so we need 18 elements, like each matrix with 9 elements, totally 18 as an our input. And this is our main file where we'll be specifying all the parameters like pragmas and all, because since we need to interface our IP with the PS, right? So once everything seems fine, we'll go for synthesis. From the synthesis report, we can see design latency, resource utility in terms of flip-flops, VRAMs and LUTs, and these are the connections which we specified using pragmas, and later on we'll be exporting RTL file. Once the RTL file is exported, we will open Vivaldi Design Suite. So we need to create new project. Here we need to specify our board which we are working on. Once everything is done, first we need to add our IP which we created in Vivaldi HLS. We'll go to the settings, and under IP we need to direct the path where our IP lies. So Our matrix multiplication IP is in the name of SML, so that has been added successfully. So further we need to go and create block diagram. While creating block diagram, the main important blocks we required are Zinc processor, DMA, our IP SML, and another block called constant. So we'll be invoking all the blocks right now. once all the blocks are invoked, we need to do some modifications. I mean, in terms of settings, we need to add some high performance ports to Jing processor. So first we will enable those things, and later on in DMA also we need to do some as of now we are just doing like high performance port. We are just enabling high performance flow port in Jing processor, and in DMA we need, since we are not using scatter encoder DMA, we will be disabling it. And after that, we need to do some manual connections between blocks. As per the video, you can follow the connections. These are basically nothing but like interfacing our IP as well as DMA. While sending the data, our IP is acting as a slave and DMA is acting as a master. And once the matrix multiplication operation is done and sending back the data, our IP is acting as a master and DMA is acting as a slave. So these connections need to be given manually. Apart from that, remaining connections will be suggested. As you guys, a minute, you people can see that green bar given by suggestion bar given by design suit. So we need to make sure that all the suggestions are cleared from our side. So DMA looks after like minute. Design suite will look after remaining connections, intermediate connections between each and every block. So once all the design connections are completed, we'll validate the circuit. And once everything is fine, then we'll wrap up the design and we'll be generating the bitstream file. May take a while. Once the bitstream file has been generated successfully, we require totally three number of files which we need to dump on our pin Z2 board. First file is like big file, like TCL file of our block diagram. And remaining two files are our big file as well as a hardware handoff file, which will be present in our project directory itself. You can follow the path which is mentioned in this particular video. Like, here is our big file, so we'll be copying this one as well. Once all the files are collected, we'll rename as per our convenience, because we'll be invoking one of our big file or one of those files in our Ping Jupyter notebook, so we'll be renaming accordingly. After renaming the files, we'll directly copy the files and dump it in our FPGA board. In this particular scenario, I copied all the files to my overlay folder. And coming to the Ping Jupyter notebook code, this is the code which we follow to invoke the overlay and perform the operation which we desire. Using question mark symbol as a syntax, we can find all the blocks which are present in our overlay. As of now, we have the main blocks like DMA as well as our IP, right? That can be viewed over here. And we'll be calling the DMA. So with the name specified in the overlay, we'll call our DMA block. And later on, we'll be assigning input and output buffer to input and output buffer to the DMA. as you guys can see, like here we are inputting 18 elements and getting 9 elements as an output. Since, as I said previously, we are working with matrix two matrix multiplication. Each matrix has 9 elements, so total 18 elements as an when the matrices are going as an input, and once the matrix multiplication is done, we'll be getting 9 elements as an output. And this is a website which we are using for crash validating our result. From this result, we can see our output results from the hardware as well as this particular website results match perfectly. So this is all for today. Thanks.